Primary Connections teaching and learning is structured into a five-phase model known as the five E's.
Engage!
Explore!
Explain!
Elaborate!
Evaluate!
The five E's model is based on theory and research that shows students learn best when they're allowed to work out explanations for themselves, from their direct experiences and with the support of their teacher. Each unit begins with a phase designed to create interest and stimulate curiosity. This phase is known as the engage phase. In this initial phase, the teacher asks open questions to draw out what students already know or think they know. Students ask questions, write, draw, and act out their understandings.
I think this seed isn't alive because it was in a packet and seeds can't grow in packets.
Hearing what the students think they know at this early phase helps the teacher take account of students' ideas and adapt following activities to build on their prior knowledge. Next, students explore by engaging in hands-on activities. Students' questions and observations are described in their own words. The explore phase allows students to acquire a common set of experiences that they can use to help each other make sense of the new concept or skill.
My one's not really healthy.
My one's this one's very big.
Doesn't look healthy. Doesn't smell healthy.
Well, mine's got roots.
Well, this one's been in a dark box all day and now it smells really bad and I don't like the smell.
Only after students have explored the concept through their own hands-on experiences and discussions does the teacher provide the scientific terms used to develop explanations. In the explain phase, opportunity is made for the students to listen to each other's explanations and to the teacher. After discussion, a literacy product is created to represent findings.
I've just finished doing our seed germination diary.
We made a presentation with PowerPoint. We're doing it on baby seeds, how they grow.
In the next phase, elaborate, opportunities are provided for students to apply what they have learnt to new situations through planning and conducting an investigation supported with an investigation planner. It's important in this phase to make sure students keep organised records of their observations. This will support students to analyse and reflect on their findings. Explanations are reconstructed and extended through integration with written language, diagrammatic and graphic examples and mathematics.
I can show you my diagram here. I've done two. And on this one, I had to label it and colour it. But on this one, you just draw yours because we did it in groups, so there were three. But this one's just mine.
In the final phase, evaluate, students review and reflect on their own learning and new understandings. Students create a new literacy product representing their understanding and providing evidence supporting their new ideas.
The 5E's model sort of provides an opportunity for children to demonstrate their prior knowledge and to build on that through exploring.
The fact that they do a lot of discovery, they make their own discoveries, is very exciting for them.
The engage stage is just so exciting.
It lures them in, it captures their imagination and they want to learn more about it.
They're very engaged and don't really realise how much they're learning, literacy particularly, through the sciences.
And they're sharing it with other kids in the playground, they're sharing it with their parents, they're sharing new understandings with me too, so you can definitely tell that it's beneficial.
I thought that the bean was dead, but now when I look at the plant life cycle, I think of it, it's alive.
And when it's fully grown to what its size is, it starts to make have flowers on it, and then the flowers fall off and they become into seed pods.
Using the 5E's model, the teacher should engage students' interests, explore through hands-on activities, explain using science ideas, elaborate by conducting student-planned investigations, and evaluate students' learning outcomes.